Hello everyone, I am Dr. Himanshu Tyagi, Consultant Spine Surgeon, Artemis Hospital. Today I will be talking to you about neck pain, or as called as cervical spondylosis in common language. Before starting, let us get a brief introduction about the anatomy or the structures present in our neck. If you look carefully at this model, you can see that our neck is composed of seven different bones. They are held together by ligaments running at the front as well as at the back of the bony structure. Bones are joined together by discs. These blue structures here represent the disc. In addition to that, we have joints at all the seven levels, which are held together firmly by a capsule. So, what happens when our neck goes bad or when it starts pain? In terms of speaking about the pain generators which can give rise to pain whenever somebody is suffering from neck pain or there is any injury, there are five different possibilities of getting neck pain because of structural damage. The first and the most important structure to get damaged are the muscles. These muscles, as known as neck muscles, they run from top to the bottom of the neck and they support our spine. Mostly when somebody is having a muscular ache, like you get up in the morning from a bad sleeping posture, you get neck pain. It is because of these muscles. Second most important reason is when the disc goes bad. This blue structure here, you can see it acts like a cushion in between all the vertebral bodies. And sometimes when the disc goes bad, as it is called as slip disc, the person starts getting pain. Third important pain generator in our spine is when we have any problem related to the joints, called as the facet joints. What happens here, because of the swelling or inflammation within this joint, as it is very common with aging problem, sometimes the patient starts getting pain on one side of the neck. One side of the neck starts getting pain and the person typically presents to us with a problem saying that I'm not able to turn my neck to one particular side. That is when we expect a facetal arthropathy problem. Next important pain generator in the spine is when the alignment of the spine, overall alignment goes bad. Normally, our spine is like this. If this is the front part, your neck is arched towards the front part. Sometimes because of the aging problem and other changes, the neck becomes straight. This improper alignment of the neck, it is very common, especially in those who are working on laptops for long hours or those who are typing on mobile for long hours. Typically, the syndrome which is known as text neck syndrome, which is very common occurring these days in young individuals, especially those tapping on the mobiles or talking on mobile in on wrong postures, they typically present to us with this type of wrong posture of the spine leading to neck pain. Next important pain generator is the nerve. The spinal cord which runs through this vertebral column from top end to the bottom end of our spine, sometimes it gets pinched. Spinal cord being a nervous tissue, whenever the nerve is getting pinched at any point within the spinal canal, it produces pain. Now, what are the common presentations? Normally, neck pain patients or neck syndromes, they present to us with localized neck pain. Sometimes the person may present as having radicular pain or radiating pain going down the arms. The person may also present as having numbness or tingling in any of the fingers of the hand. And of course, sometimes we even get frank weakness. The most troublesome sign here is weakness, because sometimes the person comes late to us and tells us, "Doctor, I'm not able to hold even a cup of coffee. There is something wrong with my hand. It starts shivering the moment it tries to hold something." Now what happens here is, because of a damage to the nerve occurring in the neck, either because of disc, either because of wrong posture or any nerve injury, the sensation, the muscle power to the hand reduces. This is the most severe problem which we see nowadays, and inevitably it leads to paralysis of the arm or the forearm and might even require surgery. Now talking about common ways of preventing these problems. Normally what happens, the person presenting to us is between the age of 30 to 50 and mostly a busy executive or a laptop worker. Wrong posture is the number one cause of neck pain as seen in today's society. Normally, such patients present to us with a history of neck pain which started after a wrong sleeping posture. It continued for 2 or 3 days and then suddenly it aggravated and is now presenting as numbness in the hand, tingling in the hand, or sometimes even weakness in the foot. These all symptoms, they should not be ignored. Normally, whenever we see a patient for the first time, we advise them rest and we advise them for correcting the posture. If somebody is working on the laptop or in habit of reading book for long hours, ideally the posture should be that the laptop should be at the level of the eyesight, so that you don't have to bend your neck down to read something. The better option is to elevate the laptop or the book to the level where your neck is straight and you are focusing straight. The eye level of the laptop should be same as your level. And whenever you require typing for long hours, rather than typing, keeping your hands like this, your hands should be well supported, your chin straight, and neck absolutely well supported. Second is, whenever you are typing on mobile, sometimes what happens, whenever we are typing, this is very common in today's age, where the youngsters are suffering from neck pain. They type in this position. This is a very wrong position to type in, because whenever you are bending your neck down, you are putting almost up to 6 times your head weight onto the disc. Bending forward at neck is not at all a good thing. So the ideal position is, you should hold the mobile up to the level where you are able to type without bending your neck down. Normally what happens if somebody is in habit of taking and talking on the mobile like this? This is the number one cause of neck pain, especially in young population who are busy, who are working on laptop simultaneously and talking on the phone. This particular posture, this thing should be avoided in all circumstances. Whenever we are bending our neck to one particular side, we are putting as much as 8 times the normal neck weight onto our joints as well as disc. In long term, this leads to compression of the nerve here at the level of the neck and paralysis or paresthesias running down the hand. One of my patients even presented with frank paralysis of the lower limbs because of this posture. He was in a habit of talking onto the phone for long hours.